Let's do some cumulative practice based on everything we've learned from acid-catalyzed dehydration, and make sure to be mindful of all the different details I taught you about which mechanism you would use and what would happen in terms of how many steps they would have and stuff like that. Now, there is one instruction that I want to give you, and that's, remember that I told you that primaries would do an E2 reaction or mechanism, and then secondaries and tertiaries would perform an E1, okay? Now, that is almost always true, but there is one exception to that. That is going to be if you have a primary alcohol that can rearrange to a tertiary carbocation through a shift, then it's actually going to do a carbocation-mediated E1 mechanism instead, okay? So you're going to have to use that information to maybe determine this first one. Notice that it is primary. Figure out, okay, this would usually be E2. If it could shift to a tertiary position, then you should actually use E1. But I'm going to let you guys figure that out. Second one, same thing. You have to figure out what mechanism and everything that would happen in between. All right? So go ahead and get started on this first one, and then I'll show you guys how to do it.